about to get a.
Welcome to Body Shop TV. My name is Chella.
And I am the Body Mechanic NYC.
Welcome, Body Mechanic. Christmas is in a couple of days.
Chris what?
Christmas is in a couple of days.
Oh my God, every day is Christmas for me.
So me too, this is true.
It's sidetracked, so. So people are going nuts right now.
The roads are totally jam-packed, mad traffic. The stores are filled. People are like getting edgy and irritable.
Filled with what?
Filled with people.
Oh, yeah.
Filled with people, and people are getting edgy and irritable. Why? That's not what this Christmas is all about.
Because they want to make sure that Santa gets his stuff so he can get wedged in the chimney. I don't know. Who knows?
Listen, Santa Claus sees me every morning when I open my eyes.
Not with all that bling on.
You like it? I'm feeling quite festive today.
I like the way how it fades into like red.
Isn't it beautiful?
It's like gold atop it.
This is one of my first Christmas presents this year.
Where'd that come from?
From a very good friend of mine, LaTanya Roman.
Yes, everybody gives Chella gifts.
Well, you get gifts all the time, Body Mechanic. No,
the only gifts I get is bee pollen.
Well, that's keeping you alive, right?
Yes.
Keeping you nice and nourished and all that.
This is my satchel of food right here. Yeah. So back to those holidays, a lot of pressure.
I know it is.
God,
people spend all their money.
Debt.
And then when it's all over in January, they're depressed, they're broke.
I have a foolproof methodology.
What is it?
I spend a dollar per person.
Oh, what, a scratch off?
You scratch something.
Go to dollar store.
Dollar store, just like, you know.
I have a better method.
That's a lot of pressure, Chella.
I know it is. I give everybody hugs and kisses.
Okay.
I mean, how priceless is that? A hug and a kiss?
Yes, I guess a hug does go further than a dollar.
Yeah, a hug goes forever. Remember when you first hugged me? Right. Yeah. Right.
But that's only because I give a dollar because I know so many people.
Oh, how many people you know?
I know about, like, in the close circle, about 500.
So you give out $500?
Yes.
All right.
That's better than spending $500 on one gift and just, you know.
I'm giving hug, kisses, and a little bit of coquito.
Folks.
Yes, homemade coquito.
Folks, let me tell you.
I make it with love and 192 proof.
Chella has a new name. It's called Betty Bootleg. Betty Bootleg Chella. That's
it. It's a family tradition.
I am not drinking any of that stuff.
This year.
No, I'm not.
Yet.
I am never, ever consuming another ounce of alcohol consciously.
Okay, I'm glad that you said it on television because...
I did. I'm not playing.
Now let the record show.
You know how much time I spend detoxifying this incredible liver? And now I'm just going to take and zap it with some of
that. It's the holidays, Body Mechanic. You got to live a little. Just have a little something, something. Just.
But your liver doesn't look at it that way. When that stuff comes in, your liver's like, oh, my God. Oh, it gets all twisted up. No, I'm not going.
Once a year. Come on. It's a tradition, Body Mechanic. You're gonna regret it. You're going to be sorry.
No, it's just like one potato chip. No one eats one potato chip.
Because this year, I made them differently.
Yeah, you made them with like 210 proof.
No, 192. 192 proof. It's delicious. People, like, they just keep calling. My phone keeps...
What is that show about? Wellness and what?
Relationships. And coquito is vital to relationships.
And now you're Betty Bootleg.
Yeah, you
go. Wow, this show is really transforming.
That was your nickname to me, Betty Bootleg. But listen, coquito is vital to healthy relationships.
You're getting calls from the president, from the NYPD, from the MTA.
Yes.
Coquito rising, everybody.
Suffolk County Police Department.
No, I'm telling you. No.
I got to tell you. Listen, you want to hear a story?
Okay.
Out of all my customers, my most popular customers are policemen.
Of course.
Isn't that something?
Right.
That's
interesting. They feel guilty about all those tickets that they gave out to people. They're just trying to make up for it.
That is very, very interesting. Policemen are my biggest.
It's a stressful job. They need Coquito.
Yeah, that and Dunkin' Donuts.
God, you are killing me today.
You know, there has to be some sort of imbalance with our show. You know, your wellness and all the stuff that you talk about, maintaining your health and good living and good eating habits, there's got to be a little flavor on the other side.
I don't know.
Let me provide the flavor.
We'll see about that the next hour when we heat you up.
I'm not getting heated up.
I don't know. They probably just detect you just being in the room. They don't even have to be
I
on
did
there.
That already. There was all kinds of heat.
Are you serious? You did?
Yeah, I went to a fair. I met with JP, and they put me in front of this machine, and the insides were like
red. Did it blot out the room?
No.
Oh.
But there was a lot of heat. He said I had a lot of heat inside.
Oh, where?
Probably because I'm Puerto Rican.
Where? Yeah, you probably was a Coquito. Really? I'm pretty sure that heats you up, too.
No, there was a lot of heat, like, in this area.
Oh, God. You are too much. You know what? I'm liking you a little better today.
Why?
Because you're like, you're coming out of your skin a little bit.
Oh,
you know, usually Chella, you're like this. For folks out there in TV land, usually Chella, when we're on the radio show, Chella is in full form. She's like walking on the table.
We had fun last night.
Body weight squats. We're hanging out with JP. We're throwing tapalin around, sprinkling people with honey. And then when we get to the TV show, Chella's like, well, the deal is.
There's a reason. There are people looking at us. It's a whole different energy, a whole different dynamic, body mechanic. Come
on. So you act differently? So you act different because?
Just a smidgen.
Because people can see you?
Yeah, just a smidgen.
But you're buck wild in public.
Like I wouldn't wear this on the radio show because nobody could see it.
Yeah, well, I can see it.
Yeah, but that's not enough.
Oh, it's a selective posse.
Right.
You know, you're killing me, Chella. I see what's up now. I'm going to just sprinkle some bee pollen on you.
So listen, you know what tomorrow is?
Hold on, let me get some bee pollen before you tell me. Just make sure
I can. Hurry up.
What's tomorrow, Chella?
Tomorrow is December 22nd. And
is that when I used to be a player back in the day until I got played?
Until you got played, yeah. Yes, until you got played.
Is that when I had orange on?
Oh, yes. We met a year ago.
It's been a whole year?
And we met a year ago tomorrow. And I just celebrate the journey. We've done a lot. We've seen a lot. We've had a lot of fun. Met a lot of great people.
Do you see what Coquito did to me? What? I lost the whole year. No. Really, it's been a whole year?
Yeah, it's been a year, man.
God, started out with an orange coat, now two shows.
Started from
later.
The bottom, now we're here.
Betty Bootleg.
It's been great. It's been great.
We've met lots of great people.
Mm-hmm.
Shed a lot of skin, too.
Lots of skin.
All I always say is that rocket ship goes into outer space, it got to peel off, you know, all the excess weight.
Sky's the limit. The limit's the sky.
That's right.
It's been great. It's been quite an experience.
So what's on the horizon for Body Shop Enterprises, Chella?
Well, we're going to do our one-year anniversary gala March 6th
yeah.
at the beautiful Carlisle Palace in Plainview.
Yes.
We have a number of honorees. As a matter of fact, our guest on the next hour is one of our honorees, JP, from Optimal Wellness of Long Island.
Yes, Optimal Wellness of Long Island.
We're actually honoring the owners of Madhouse TV, all four of them. That's going to be exciting.
That's the first place where Chella had her closed colonic.
That's right. Optimal Wellness, that's right. My closed colonic, yeah.
Right. They had to strap it to the table. It was crazy.
That was interesting, doing that colonic in front of individuals.
You mean all the people that were in the room?
Yeah, that was...
Yeah, it was like a colonic... like a colonic...
Exposé.
Exposé.
A colonic party.
Because JP was like, hold on, look at that spaceship flying through there. What's that? Hold on, it's coming back.
That was interesting.
Yeah.
Remember when he saw those things that looked like corn kernels going across?
Nematodes.
Because I had...
He says it better than me. We'll wait till we get him on.
Yeah, he said I had too much parasites in my system from eating sushi.
Looked like you had a colony. It's interesting.
Because, you know, I haven't had sushi since.
I know. After that, we were like, done.
And I don't even miss it.
As I recall, Chella, we used to do about...
Oh, my, three times a week.
Three or four hibachis
Hibachi
a week.
And sushi. Yep.
That's a good way to get the name out, too.
What name?
Paved the Road to... Body Shop Enterprise, just sprinkle, let him just throw the cards right on the grill. When he does a little choo-choo train with the onion. Wasn't that fun?
Oh, I missed it. Hibachi, we went to Hibachi, we weren't eating that much sushi. But we went to the sushi bar.
No, but that could have been in you. could have been in you for a while.
This is true.
Because I didn't have any.
Sushi?
I didn't have any of those toads.
Yeah. Well, your eating habits are much different than mine. You don't eat Vienna mocha chunk like I do.
And I don't drink coquito, that's true. Well, I was then.
Oh my goodness.
No, by that time the coquito had died off because it was like in the middle of the year.
He OD'd on coquito last holiday.
But I think Betty Bootleg's gonna have it. She's gonna have a summertime run too.
I think I'm gonna make it all year long because people are calling me. This phone has not stopped ringing. I cannot tell you because I make it different this year.
Wait a minute, how much do you charge for it?
Right now?
Don't you have like a sliding scale?
Yeah,
depends upon your income? Is that how it works?
No, you're silly. No,
it's scale.
No, I do. I have two prices.
That's it. I mean, you have a sliding scale. Is it based on the shoes they wear?
No, it's based on the size of the bottle.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, I would look at him and go, "Oh, you. This is a $50 bottle."
So let's talk about some more fun experiences that we've had in the last year. So we met in December. The first event was you met my business partner who has some health issues.
Yes.
And we tried to, you know, help him along the way. It was good seeing him last night, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, it's been an interesting journey. I learned a lot about gender-specific, there's a difference between dealing with men and dealing with women. It's very challenging, actually. Yeah. I find men very challenging to deal with. It's one of the biggest lessons I learned this year. It's like, whenever I'm introduced to a man who needs help, it's like I have to get past the ego and then we can get down to brass tacks and help them. Otherwise, if we don't get past the ego, nothing changes. It's just like, you're telling me something that I don't know, I have a problem with that. I don't know, Chella. You know what I'm talking about. I don't even know how to put it in words. It's kind of disheartening, actually.
Yeah.
But women, I work with all kinds of people, and I work with children.
That's because women want you. That's why they're receptive to you, because they want the body mechanic.
No, I just think that with the two opposite genders, I just think that there's no competition. I think that with the same gender, it's like, and I don't think I approach people like with a club and beat them on the head. And
you're only trying to help them.
And you know what's interesting? When you're trying to introduce new things to people, I think that allopathic medicine has made things so complicated. And when you're straightforward with them and you tell them something that's really simple, they go, that's just too easy. How come they're not doing that? They don't understand about the profit motive and all that other stuff. And I don't want to be a theorist or whatever, but the deal is people are using these old techniques and they've been around for thousands of years and they work. Just that they've been watered down in this culture because there's no money to be made. There's money to be made, but not the kind of money that they're making when they can treat your symptom and then treat extra symptoms that the pills give you. So, but you know, it's a learning process, and hopefully we continue to evolve. And I just have to figure out a different way to attack males.
You know, what's one thing that we've done really well this year? The touch sensoriums.
Yes.
Those have been a hit, and what they are monthly wellness networking events where we provide free massages, free veggie juicing. We do it at the Optimal Wellness of Long Island, where they provide other wellness modalities like Adionic foot soaks and all kinds of
things. Those foot soaks.
And the magic rods that JP makes you hold to see what's going on inside your body.
I saw one lady do a foot soak like a forest came out of the bucket. Oh my God. The last one we had at
Jewel.
At Jewel. She fell asleep and looked like, like a tree was growing out of it. I got nervous. I was afraid to get near the bucket, actually. No, that's really interesting. You know what? A lot of people don't realize that the biggest organ of the body is the skin, and it's a two-way street. And that system pulls in things from its external environment all the time, right down from chlorine that comes up in the toilet to, you know, electricity that's, you know, circulating in the air. Our bodies are just huge receptors, like a big sponge.
Well, that particular individual has a lot of stuff going on.
Who, the one who had the tree growing out by her leg?
Yeah.
I love her.
She's sweet.
Yeah.
She's sweet. Yeah. So what other successes have we had this year?
Oh, no, we had a lot of things we were introduced to, things that, because, you know, I've been privy to work with all different people in the industry, and just like, I just rant and raved about Optimal Wellness. I mean, we met Dr. Ford and
his beautiful wife.
Why do I keep messing this up? Those ceramic discs.
Right.
That he uses. Incredible. Yeah. And I am the ultimate skeptic, but let me tell you, put the whammy on me. Yeah. And today will be nothing short of that. Today will be spectacular, too.
Yeah, so we're going to have JP with us today, who's from Optimal Wellness of Long Island. He has this mechanism where he attaches his laptop to some computer that does like an infrared scanning of your body.
Scan the body.
To see what's going on internally. So I think he's going to do
Did you say you tried it, too?
I did it.
Oh, that's where you had like the hot spot.
I had the hot spots coming down this area.
Really? Yeah. What did they tell you?
I don't remember.
Did they say you were Puerto Rican?
No, I said I was Puerto Rican. I don't know.
Oh, you made that. Okay, I thought it was real. I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, it is real. Well, I don't know why it was hot. I forgot what he said.
I can feel some of the heat right now.
I feel hot.
Even your mic is turned glowing red, Chella. Let's see, what else? What else have we done?
Met a lot of cool people.
Lots and lots of people.
The De Blasis.
De Blasis, Dossie
Construction.
Tommy V. Tommy Wernette. Who else?
Oh, your new business partners. How can we forget that?
Oh, yes. David Einbinder. And Rob and Allie. Yeah, there's
Roseanne Simeon. A lot of great people.
Yeah.
A lot of great experiences.
Yeah, we shed a lot of skin, too.
Yep, a whole lot.
Yeah.
But, you know, every day's a school day.
And then this came about.
Yeah. So we put a card in the King Cullen grocery store.
No, you just throw them around everywhere.
No, I strategically place our business cards everywhere I go.
Somebody like create like a vector and eye angle when they come in, like.
Yes, you know. It's strategic because when Victoria, the owner of Madhouse, was walking out of the King Cullen, I had it placed right at eye level. I do this really well.
Oh, yes. Like they do in the supermarket with
right.
the candy aisle,
with the
most popular candy.
Exactly. So there's a community board where everybody has all their business cards and all their advertisements. I had mine at eye level, exactly eye level.
I see.
And she
and that
called
color
us the
is
next
a little enticing also.
Very, Body Shop Blue. And she
blue.
Called us the next day, and here we are.
Yeah, started from the bottom, now we're here.
Yeah, I feel like family here. Yeah.
You know, I had a flashback the other day. I was looking at my phone, and I came across this photograph of this burnt sienna chocolate shaft-like coat. It took me right back.
It did?
Yeah.
Are you going to wear it again?
I think I'm going to wear it soon, like next week. Maybe on
when
Christmas.
When it gets cold?
When it gets cold.
Okay. That's not. I like the coat now.
No, you don't. It's
I don't know. I just the color rust just doesn't do much for me. I don't know. Maybe I need to just. You know how they say
you need to
address
let go.
Your fears.
You need to take I need a deep to, breath.
No, I need to just buy something that's rust color and wear it. Just dive in.
I don't know. You whipped me.
Yeah.
See, I'm trying to get back to rust now. So look. What else? What else we got going on? We had Dr. Sabi calling on our show, and I went to Honduras.
Oh, yeah.
We had Tommy Pockets, Brenda. We had a bunch of people.
Yes. So stay tuned. Give us a call. We're going to have an awesome next hour. And
yes.
We'll be right back.
Yes, we will.
YesWeCare.net is a 501c3 charity that provides help to veterans and their families. Please visit YesWeCare.net and donate in any way you can by purchasing our beautiful frame prints or relaxation CDs and DVDs, even smooth jazz CDs. YesWeCare.net. Remember, our troops are on their way home. They need all the support they can get. YesWeCare.net.
Welcome to Formula Auto Wash, where every day is a great day for a car wash. Open 7 days a week from 8 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Sundays, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Detailing packages for every budget, starting out at $29.99. 100% hand wash and detail center. Hog's hair and microfiber brushes and mitts. Proudly using Ecolab Blue Coral soaps and waxes. Formula Auto Wash has served the community for over 30 years. Senior discounts all day, every day. Ladies Day Wednesday, $3 off any wash. Early bird discount Monday through Thursday till 9:30 a.m. Check out our website, formulaautowash.com.
Welcome back to Body Shop TV. My name is Chella.
And I am the Body Mechanic NYC.
And the purpose, stop the name of love. And the purpose of Body Shop TV is to provide you with wellness information as well as information on relationships for the longevity of both.
Yes, wellness and relationships.
And coquito.
And hanging out with Betty Bootleg. Yes.
I'm loving this chocolate candle. You know,
is
I love chocolate.
It is?
Yes.
It's chocolate?
Mm-hmm. It smells good.
Oh, my God.
Smells like Vienna mocha chunk.
Hold on. Let me taste it. That is good.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, so talking about chocolate, you went nuts last night on the chocolate.
Oh, that big box of chocolate. Oh, that's my weakness, man.
Oh, my God. Chella had, like, almond crisp on the side of her face talking. It got all over the mic.
That's my weakness. I love chocolate.
You are so funny. I know. It triggers a response in your brain. You can't help yourself. But I've totally detached myself away from that because I know 10 minutes later, I know how I feel after I ingest it.
You know, I got to tell you, this year in trying to live a better, healthier life, it's very hard. It's hard as hell.
It sure is.
It takes discipline.
It takes commitment.
You know, last night we were talking about sugar, and what JP was talking about last night, how you only need a certain amount of sugar per day, and what people consume in a matter of a year is ludicrous. And you know how you say when you walk down the grocery aisle, this food like talks to you.
Yeah.
Like I can't go down the freezer aisle because I'll get ice cream.
It doesn't talk to me because I put my earplugs in when I go in.
It's hard. And I think about people who are like morbidly obese. It's hard.
It's hard for them because a lot of the foods that they're eating are actually, they're designer addictive foods. There are things that are put in the food designed to make it addictive.
And not only that, they have to undergo a lot of psychological counseling.
Well, I always say that in order for you to change things with your body, you have to change your paradigm in your mind.
That's right.
The shift has to happen in your mind. So
and your environment,
right?
Your family environment.
Right, right, right. It has to start here. But more importantly, what I find is that most people who have difficulty sticking to things is because they really don't understand or appreciate what this thing does or how it's affected by its external environment. So when you say something to someone, you go, well, that's bad, they hear bad all the time. But if you know, like when JP was explaining to you about alcohol, mm-hmm. like if you really understand what alcohol, if people really understood exactly what's happening to the liver when they ingest alcohol, they would stop drinking.
Like the 192 proof?
Oh my God. It's like eating shards of glass. It really is.
I think everyone should buy a bottle of Michael Gito this holiday season, and come January 1st, the Body Mechanic and I will help you get back on track to living a healthier life.
I don't know, I get nervous because I'm afraid to touch those people that are loaded with Coquito because I know it'll be coming out through their pores. Poor liver. First thing I do is pound the liver first. No, I mean, liver is one of your most vital organs. It cleanses everything. It keeps the body clean, and alcohol does grave damage to the liver.
Yeah.
And that's not stopping you from selling it, of course.
No. Someone said I should make it for Valentine's Day and color it red, St. Patrick's Day, color it green.
Well, I think you should put like a liver on the back and put like a circle with a cross through it.
Hey, that's not a bad idea.
I know.
For my roughneck friends.
No, people really love it then. My liverizer. I like that, tenderizing the liver. Mm-hmm. No, what else? What else we do this year?
I know, when I'm not forced to think about it, I can't remember. I can remember everything. I can't remember now. I've done a lot of years gone really fast.
Well, you know, we started the radio, what, 10 months ago?
February.
Wow, the radio is a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. Nice following.
Nice following, yep. And we have a great engineer.
Yeah, George, he's great.
Yep. We toyed with the idea of FM. And
right.
That kind of fell through because of the coverage.
Right, it was only giving us half the island, not even half, less than half of the Long Island. Yeah. So where we are, we have great tri-state coverage.
And then this gives us a lot of range.
But yeah, we're in 72 countries.
I have people all over the world that are actually watching the show. On my Facebook family, I have about 800, 900 followers on there. You probably have like 10 million.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
I don't have that many.
Charlie, you have 9,000 people in your...
That was then, now I have more. Contacts in my phone.
Just 10,000 contacts.
No, a little over 9.
Okay, give or take a couple thousand. Most people don't even have 100. That's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm really excited about the next hour.
Me too.
I can't wait to see that stuff. What else has JP introduced us to? We've Dr. Ford with the ceramic disc, JP with the foot soak, with the...
The colonic, the clothes. We've also had open colonic.
Yes, we did. Which one do you prefer, Chella?
I love the open because I'm alone.
You like being alone?
I like being in the lone room because I get to like meditate, play on my tablet. But I don't like the after effects of the open. I like the after effects of the closed.
What do you mean?
Like the open system, everything that you just that comes out of you comes out into a big open basin and it's open. I don't like that. I like the closed system where everything goes through a tube. And I like the fact that you can see it throughout the tube. But if JP is standing over you, massaging you, he's blocking the view and you can't really see what's coming out.
Just give him the left his elbow.
Right, make a move.
Right.
I wish the tube was bigger, like maybe on a screen.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
You mean like visuals. Amplify it.
Right, people like visuals. You know, to be able to see what's coming out of you and to know what it is, I mean, have him there so he can describe what's coming out.
That's a game changer.
That's awesome.
Because right now, I have a vivid image of that nematode. Can you imagine that was blown up? I'd probably run out the room like a flying saucer.
Because the layperson who would see these things look like corn kernels coming out, you would think you had ingested corn, but I haven't had corn in many, many months.
Right, exactly.
So it's educational. I like both. I like both.
No, but you know what? You just made an interesting point. Seeing what's going on inside your body really is a game changer.
You mean seeing what's coming out?
Right.
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 Yeah.
Right. Seeing what's going on is really a game changer. And look how effective it was as far as eating sushi and stuff. You stopped just like that.
Now, when I had the open colonic, that snake came out of me. Remember?
Right.
I wonder if a snake can come out through a closed system.
Right,
we gotta ask JP.
I don't know. Not the size of your snake. He would be a tube like that big. That snake was an anaconda.
Explain what a snake is, silly.
through years and years of eating
Vienna mocha chunk,
you know, I don't like using, well, eating foods that are not favorable for your body. I mean, foods are loaded with so many different things. There's different toxins and pesticides. And what happens is this mucosa lining that forms on the inside of your colon or your intestines can sometimes get loaded with those toxins and become very hard. And Chella had pain in her left side
upper
of her
left.
Rib cage. Left side, right?
Upper left.
Upper left side of her rib cage. For how long?
Months.
It was longer than months.
About 6 months.
Yeah.
Progressively getting worse. And I started doing the colonics and coffee enemas.
I got you doing coffee enemas. And then when she went for her second colonic,
snake.
Right, this encasing that was this mucosa lining that was wedged up inside her colon came out. It was probably about, what, 12 to 15 inches long?
Yeah.
Yeah, it looked just like her colon. Mm-hmm. It's amazing. And then after that, the pain went away.
Yep.
Just like that. And what's interesting is that you went for a colonoscopy.
Oh, yeah, that was exciting. I went for colonoscopy 3 years ago or 3.5 years ago. They found 2 polyps. And he said, since we found a polyp, you got to come back in 3 years. Now, this is interesting. My mom said, it was a physician assistant. Yeah. She said that once they find a polyp, you're supposed to come back every year. But this doctor told me to come back in 3 years. Well, anyway, regardless.
Depends on how much money they need to make. It depends on.
This is true. You know. So anyway, I went back 3 years later.
Depends what the budget is.
And I had my second colonic done. And this was post doing several colonic. I had a colonoscopy done, I'm sorry, after 3 years. This was post doing several colonics and coffee enemas, and they didn't find any polyps whatsoever.
In fact, their colon was clean.
And he was actually spending more time digging and searching for polyps and couldn't find anything. It was clean sweep.
That is huge.
Mm-hmm.
That is huge. Right. I mean, everybody's pollinized walking around.
Yeah.
Yeah, so after that came out, I mean, you haven't had that pain since, right?
Nope. But my challenge now is working out. I gotta get my body active.
Well, you know,
I'm drinking the water, I'm juicing when I remember. I'm not eating like I used to eat. My diet has changed tremendously. But to get my body moving, I'm not motivated. I need to hire a body mechanic. A real one.
You know, that's really hard to believe that you're not motivated. Whenever you
I'm
wanna
not,
do something,
I know, I'm not.
You know what it is? It's just that it's not a priority to you.
Yeah.
Well, what's up with that?
Here, we could do this. If it's for us.
That is one for us, I can tell.
Oh, okay.
I can tell by the number.
So, body mechanic, get back to my motivation.
Huh?
Get back to my motivation.
What about your motivation?
Good answer.
You have reached Madhouse Studios, the home of Madhouse TV and Madhouse Radio.
I don't think they're ready for us.
Okay.
But get back to my motivation.
I think that it's because you're not making it a priority.
Like I make other things a priority.
Yeah, like you make your hair and
my coquito.
Coquito. Because if you put the same vengeance towards that, you'd be rolling. So
this
I think what
true.
You're doing now is something that's simple you can do on your own.
And my squats?
Right.
And I found that fun and easy.
That's what I mean.
I enjoyed that. I do 20.
With a two-minute break.
Two-minute break, squats, and I find myself, as the squats progress, I go deeper and deeper.
Right, as your body starts to warm up.
Right.
Now, what's incredible about doing a squat mechanism, it affects your entire body. Another thing is, what I did with my corporate wellness program is I incorporate exercise that stimulate the lymphatic system.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
So, we have a caller?
I think so.
All right. Let's.
Okay. You know what? Let's go to a commercial. We'll break.
Yeah, all right.
And then we'll come back.
Okay, cool beans.
And we'll talk more about Chella's commitment to her exercise.
Or maybe you can help me get some encouragement.
I think you're on the right path.
We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Eve Eva, one of our 4 million owners, has her cat insured with Folksam. This one is for you.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar.
Visit folksam.se and tell us what makes your heart beat faster.
Welcome back to Body Shop TV. My name is Chella.
And I am the shy body mechanic NYC.
And we have a caller. Welcome to Body Shop TV. We are
excellent.
On top of the world.
And who's calling?
Wonderful. This is Coco from Connecticut.
Coco from
CCC.
CCC.
What's up?
And I just wanted to do a toot-toot on the coffee enema conversations that you were having, because I tell you, I'm addicted. I'm addicted to it. Mm. I love doing my coffee enemas. I was introduced to it by Mr. Body Mechanic. And I can't help myself. I'm just done.
How often do you do them, Coco?
I'll skip a week, but I do it 3 times a week, and then I'll skip a week and do it 3 times a week. You know, pretty much. That's pretty much what I do. But I love to do. I was doing it one time, like 5 to 6 times a week. And I just thought that was, I was just kind of overdoing it, according to my family. What's wrong with you? You're doing another one of those things?
Well,
and I'm like,
well, you know what's interesting? Your family doesn't know about that. So if you don't mind, Coco, you mind sharing with us some of the things that are going on with you?
Absolutely, absolutely. As you know, Mr. Body Mechanic, I was diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer September. Actually, it was June that I was diagnosed, but I did have surgery in September. But I opted not to do the traditional approach to cancer, which is chemo and radiation. I was totally against that. It just didn't fit well with me. And I knew that there were options, alternatives, and choices that I could make. And I began to start seeking out and calling people and saying, hey, I need some help. And I called you, Mr. Body Mechanic, and said, help me. I do not want to do chemo and radiation. I just do not want to do chemo and radiation. And there has to be an alternative solution to this. And rightfully so, you kind of guided me. And one of the things you had mentioned to me was to get the book, Cancer, Step Outside of the Box. Mm-hmm. And that was the best book I ever could have bought. You are absolutely right. And here's a short story quick. I went into the city to Chinatown to look for this mushroom that I was looking for, and no one could speak English. And so they found some woman walked into the store off the street, and she kind of overheard the conversation and said, what is it you're looking for? What is it that you want? I said, I'm looking for Ganoderma reishi mushrooms. And anyway, she translated to the people in the store, but she said, why are you getting it? And I said, she says, for cancer? And I said, yes. Then she pulls reaches into her pocketbook and says, you have to get this book. And guess what book it was?
Oh, that's funny.
Right. I just said, this is too cool. This is, it's the same book you told me to get. And here was someone else telling me that I should get the book. So
yes,
I knew that I was right on point too.
Yes, cancer outside the box.
Their path.
So
yes.
Coco, where are you now with the cancer issue?
The last time I had testing, it was clear. Hadn't spread, hadn't gone to any of the organs in my body. Mm-hmm. So I'm just doing everything organically and juicing and doing my coffee enemas and just trying to eat right and live right.
How do you feel?
Fabulous.
Good for you, Coco. Coco, have you tried colonics yet?
I'm sorry?
Have you tried a colonic yet?
I've had one in the past, but since hearing you two speak, I know that tomorrow, or I should say Monday, I need to get on the phone and make a phone call and get it done.
Yeah, you should come down to Long Island and go to Optimal Wellness of Long Island. They're awesome.
Wow.
They're awesome.
Long Island is so long away. But, yeah, if I'm in the area, I certainly wouldn't be opposed to that at all.
I'd love to meet you, Coco.
Wonderful. Wonderful. I have to do that.
Well, you know what? Good. Listen, the next time you come, body mechanic.
What?
I heard.
Okay. Sorry. The bling was blocking my ears. I'm sorry.
I took the bling off, body mechanic. Okay. Haven't you noticed? Coco.
Yes.
When you come to Long Island, we'd like to offer you a free one on the house.
Oh, my.
Compliments of Optimal Wellness of Long Island.
I would also like to have her on the show.
What did he say?
We would also have to have you on the show when you come to Long Island. We'll schedule it.
We'll do a combo pack.
Yeah.
Show and colonic.
That sounds fantastic. I would love to do it because, you know, I am also trying to educate people since I've decided to take this approach and the feeling that I'm receiving. I mean, I tell you, I really feel great. I really, really do. And I have to thank you, Body Mechanic, because he's been an inspiration and a motivation.
That's awesome.
And I just have to throw that out there. So thank you.
Thank you so much.
But there's so many people that need to know that there are options, alternatives, and choices to make, and you don't have to go with the traditional approach.
Right.
There are other ways of doing it. And
Coco, you got to be open to that.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a certain individual.
Absolutely. Absolutely. That's so true. I love your show, guys. I really do. Oh. Thank you so much for allowing me to call in, and I'm going to take you up on that offer.
Please do,
absolutely.
Coco.
Absolutely.
Have a wonderful holiday, honey.
And thank you for calling.
So much. And thank you, and have a good one.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.
You get so excited, Body Mechanic.
What do you mean?
Tell her.
She was a friend of mine who I met about 15 years ago, and I didn't know she was going through that. And then one day she messaged me on Facebook, and she heard about my trip when I went to Honduras, and I was talking about Honduras. Mm-hmm. And then she called and asked me what she should do. So I gave her, you know, a few regimens to do. So she's doing oil pulling, she's doing the enemas.
And the
she's doing castor
packs. Castor
packs.
Okay, good.
Interesting is that she looks great, and her family can't, her friends can't believe it, because she's changed her eating habits. She changed, and she's detoxifying her body.
Good for
That's
you.
That's the key. You see what's interesting? Her family is telling her that 5 coffee enemas a week
was
is
excessive.
Too much. When I study anti-cancer protocols by Max Gerson, when someone is in stage 4. They are doing 6 a day, every 4 hours. Mm. So those people that are trying to speculate what is wrong and what's right, they have no idea what they're talking about. First of all, most of them don't even know exactly what happens when you do a coffee enema.
I'm happy for Coco.
Absolutely. I'm extremely excited. I can't wait to have her. And she's awesome. She writes children's books, and she's a motivational speaker, everything. She's cool.
Great. So get back to getting me motivated.
Right. So I think that the fact is that when you, like you used to say on a radio show, you know what? I'm a kind of get her done kind of girl.
Right, I am.
So it's just a matter of you making it a priority. And if I think if you take the same vengeance that you do, like in the morning when you're putting on your mascara and brushing your teeth and making sure that the bling is situated the right way.
Right.
I think that the exercise regimen will be, because for me, working out is like breathing, just like my food,
but,
and taking care of my temple.
But keep in mind, and no disrespect, that took work. You had to build up to that level. You didn't wake up one morning and said, your workout regimen is like breathing. It wasn't that important to you immediately from the onset.
I'll tell you, when I set my sight on something, nothing will deter me from it. I've always been like that. And now that
I'm the same way.
Right, and now that I understand and appreciate, really, as I learn more and more about how incredible this temple is, it's really easy for me to have the blinders on when it comes to that stuff. And I think that's where the problem is, because people don't really appreciate this thing and understand that when you take something into your mouth, it directly affects the entire body. Mm-hmm. They don't get that. And that's why when we did the thing at Optimal Wellness,
were able to see what was kind of going on inside your body. It really gave you that connection.
Yeah.
To see how I broke that chain from us going and, you know.
That's true.
So, and this squat thing is easy. It makes you feel good. I have 5 or 6 clients in the city who suffer from depression. And I got them on a squat regimen. And in the morning when they do their squats, they feel good for 5 and 6 hours after they do the squat. Mm-hmm. And now they're clients of mine. I train them. It's the first thing that most doctors tell you when you suffer from depression is to get your body moving.
I'm doing it in the morning and at night.
Excellent. You can get up to, you can do a couple hundred squats a day, and I'm telling you, it will change your whole entire body.
I'm doing 100.
It stimulates fat-burning enzymes. It stays with you longer than doing cardio work. It can reach into the anaerobic threshold. It's going to build heart strength. It actually will strengthen your back muscles, leg muscles, glutes.
But I need you to show me how far I should be going down. Should I drop it like it's hot?
You like to drop it like it's hot, like you're trying to pick up coins off the floor. You don't need to get that low. What you want to do is you can bring your quadriceps down to parallel, and that's really deep enough. But more importantly, you want to, it's like you're sitting up. A lot of people, when they do a squat, they lean forward. But you want to actually have your chest open, engage your core slightly as you go down.
Yeah, that's challenging. That's harder
down,
to do.
And then you exit. When you go against gravity, you exhale into gravity. And it's that simple. And you can do it. You don't need any apparatus. You do it barefoot. That way you get the proper mechanisms, the proper muscle recruitment with your quads and your hips and your ankles. It's the best thing. I do all my classes that I teach, every class, we do, in that 25-minute or 35-minute period that we train, we do anywhere from 100 to 200 squats.
So Body Mechanic, I'm looking forward to the next year.
Yes.
With Body Shop Enterprises, Body Shop TV, Body Shop Radio. Mm-hmm. Body Shop, whatever else we're going to be doing in 2014. And I just want to say that it's been a great journey with you thus far.
Absolutely.
I enjoy your
and
company.
And the sky really is the limit.
It is. And it's, I love it. Every day's a school day. And I look forward to 2014 with you.
And I can't lie. I've laughed more in the last year than I've laughed the 51 years before that.
We do laugh a lot. Oh, my goodness.
In fact, we laugh so much, people are like, what's wrong with y'all?
Yeah, why? How come they're so happy?
That's another thing we notice. Like, everywhere we go, like, you can't laugh.
I know. It's like when we go out, we have to change our mode or
become
neutral.
Right,
become neutral because everybody around us is, like, so miserable.
We have to, like, snicker. Like, seriously, everywhere we go, people
are... Couples are on their phones, not communicating with each other.
Oh, that's the big... Remember that time we went to that... We went to this restaurant in Babylon, and we were up above, what is that sushi place? What's it called?
Sumo? The one where everybody got sick? Babylon?
It's in Babylon. The one we went to where we sat up top, we got that special, we were getting those special, they had the sushi rolls
Monsoon.
Monsoon.
Fidel Sassoon.
Yeah.
That place is very, very nice.
You know what? We'll talk about that in a sec. Let's pay a couple of bills, and then we'll come back and talk about Monsoon. We could talk about what we saw in there.
I want to bring JP on. I'm excited about him being here.
Me too.
Let's bring him in back. That's a commercial.
Yeah.
All right, yeah.
Okay, let's do
it. We'll be right back.
All right.
You know you already want a Toyota, but when you want more from your Toyota store, you want Smithtown Toyota, where every Toyota comes with Smithtown Toyota's Toyota for Life program, giving you lifetime New York State inspections, lifetime 10% discounts on all parts and service, 2 years of complimentary oil changes, 2 years of scheduled maintenance, and more, all at no cost to you, plus low clear-out deals on every Toyota in stock. Get more from your Toyota store. Hurry to Smithtown Toyota.
Yeah. Like so many people, are your finances tight lately? Afraid to open your mail or even answer your phone? Well, take heart. You don't have to live like that. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you can join the thousands of folks who have used safe and effective government-insured reverse mortgages. The government-insured reverse mortgages from Long Island's Senior Reverse Network allow you to stay in your home and turn equity into tax-free cash. Our government-insured reverse mortgages can eliminate mortgage payments, credit card balances, or just improve your lifestyle. Do yourself a favor and solve these problems now. Call the Senior Reverse Network, and our advisors will answer all of your questions about our reverse mortgage programs. We've helped scores of senior Long Island homeowners like you who now enjoy a worry-free retirement. Get the financial security and peace of mind you've dreamed about. Pick up the phone and call us at the Senior Reverse Network now to set up a free consultation.
Call 1-800-985-REVERSE. That's 1-800-985-7383.
When your cable's on the fritz, you get frustrated. When you get frustrated, your daughter imitates. When your daughter imitates, she gets thrown out of school. When she gets thrown out of school, she meets undesirables. When she meets undesirables, she ties the knot with undesirables. And when she ties the knot with undesirables, you get a grandson with a dog collar. Don't have a grandson with a dog collar. Get rid of cable and upgrade to DirecTV. Call 1-800-DIRECTV.
Eva, one of our 4 million owners, has her cat insured with Folksam. This one is for you.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar.
Visit folksam.se and tell us what makes your heart beat faster.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
Welcome back to Body Shop TV. My name is Shella.
And I am the Body Mechanic NYC.
Body Mechanic, you were talking earlier about how we laugh a lot. Everywhere we go, it's really, really cool. People are inspired by our happiness.
I heard you laughing in the bathroom, actually. What are you laughing
at? Oh, stop it. I'm going to take a phone call. Welcome to Body Shop TV.
Hi, this is Bob from New Jersey. I have a question to ask you.
Hi, Bob. Welcome.
I was just wondering, I'm kind of like new to this coffee enema. Does it matter if I get my coffee like from Dunkin' Donuts or Starbucks, or does it have to be from 7-Eleven, anything in particular?
Well, that's a very interesting point. No, what's recommended for doing coffee enemas is organic coffee. And
so I can run on Dunkin' Donuts then?
No.
You got
to buy.
Can you run on Dunkin' Donuts? I mean, you could probably get by and do one if you had to. But ultimately, what you want to do is you want to do an organic light roast. That's what you want to do.
And cook it.
Organic light roast, milk, no sugar, right?
You know what? And if you add sugar and milk, you're on your own, buddy. No, it's good.
I was just checking it out, you know. Thank you very much. And I guess I'll be running on Dunkin' Donuts 3 days a week. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Take care.
Bye. He's funny.
I'm happy surprised that people would try milk and sugar.
Can you imagine?
Putting sugar in there? That would be catastrophic.
But you know what was interesting? That we put a teaspoon or a tablespoon of...
Don't give away the secrets of the trade.
Okay, Body Mechanic, but I'm telling you, it reduces cramping.
Yes.
You should share the love.
One of the interesting points about doing the coffee enema is, first of all, the volume size. If you're starting out and you're new to the process, you want to start out with maybe 16 ounces and then work your way up. And if you're doing it for the first time, what I recommend you do is actually do a saline flush. So just use distilled water and use a tablespoon of unrefined sea salt, Celtic or Himalayan mine salt, to kind of clean the system out, and then you'll get better absorption of the caffeine through the colon wall.
And no cramping.
Right, and no cramping. But the salt will definitely help with minimizing the cramping. In fact, when you use salt, there is no cramping at all. Mm-hmm. And I know that because I've tried both on and off, and when I don't have the salt as part of the solution, it's very difficult to hold the solution. So.
Yeah. So you were making a point before we went to break about laughing so much and being out in public.
Oh, when I heard you when you were in the bathroom, because you laughed.
I was not in the.
You probably laugh in your sleep, Chella.
I know. My daughter told me that one time when she was living with me.
That means life is good. When you chuckle in your sleep, holla. I tell you.
So what was the point you were going to make? You were going to say something about monsoon.
Oh, right. So we went to this restaurant called Monsoon. Excellent, excellent. It's in Babylon.
Yes.
This is just before we took our break away from sushi and Nematoidville.
Yes.
So...
the sushi rolls are $25.
Yeah.
The cowboy roll.
Yeah. Well, that's why we was up top. They put us in the VIP section.
Wow.
You were wearing Body Shop Blue. I had the shoes on.
Not that I pay for it, but I just noticed.
Don't start, Chella. Why do you make it a point to say that? Okay. So we're sitting there and we're just casually observing because it was kind of in the evening and they had a lounge downstairs in the bar. And what we saw were people half of the populace down there on that floor was actually engaged in the conversation and simultaneously using their cell phone. Everybody was LinkedIn. Remember,
yeah.
We were like counting the people. I'm telling you, cell phones have become like a sidearm.
Yeah, yeah. Remember last night when JP was with us in the studio, the radio studio? He had me hold my cell phone in one hand.
You know, JP doesn't carry a cell phone, right?
I know. He's smart.
He knows.
So he tried to push my hand down with the cell phone in the other hand, and I couldn't hold the hand up.
Right.
No, wait. He was trying to hold my...
It's called muscle testing, and then what he did was he took and put that electronic device in your hand.
Tried to push my hand down.
And when he pushed... I don't know. I don't have JP's powers. He's got the special touch.
Yes, he does. With the magic rods.
When he put that electronic device in your hand, all of a sudden you felt weaker.
Yeah, I did.
You couldn't resist, right?
It does take away your strength, your energy.
Yep. And you never put that thing down. As a matter of fact,
it's always down, and I always use it on speaker body.
If I'm not mistaken, I'd be willing to bet that if we would happen to sneak into your place while you were showering, I guarantee your hand is sticking outside the shower stall with the phone in your hand.
No, I leave it.
Miss a call.
I leave it on the sink. But I stopped that. You know why? Because I heard that the humidity from the steam.
Oh, may mess up your phone.
Yeah, it can cause damage.
Right, but what the radiation does to your body is not that important.
Oh, yeah, right. I got you. Right. Okay. Anyway, come on. I want to introduce our sponsor.
Yes, 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 yes.
We have an awesome sponsor who's been with us from the beginning of our journey, Optimal Wellness of Long Island. We've partnered with them. We host our Touch Sensoriums there. And JP has just given us a wealth of information and awesome energy. And JP, welcome to Body Shop TV.
Well, thank you, Chella.
You're like family.
And you too, Body Shop.
Yes, Mr. JP.
So, JP, what toys do you have with us today?
Well, today we're going to speak about thermography, which is thermal imaging, all right? And we're going to talk about, in particular, breast thermography.
Oh.
All right.
I'm getting hot flashes already just looking.
Okay. So what we want to look at is why would we want to do thermography?
Mm-hmm.
Basically, the healthcare system is really like a system designed to take care of illness and not really to prevent illness.
Does this replace the mammogram?
No, it doesn't want to work the same way a mammogram does. And a mammogram is going to find something after the problem is already there, where the thermography, what you want to do with a thermography is you want to be able to find the problem before, when it's only beginning, in the very early stages. So the problem with a mammogram, you have a number of things. One thing is that it's extremely painful, and radiation.
Don't they squeeze the breast tissue?
Oh, they have to actually flatten it right out in order to take the pictures.
Right.
And then the other thing is that it is radiation, so you're being radiated.
So that's collective. Right? I mean, each one you have.
Oh, yeah. Actually, and then... The other thing is that it doesn't really find anything until something is physically there. And if you look at a breast cancer cell, the way a breast cancer cell develops, like what happens is Every 90 days, it multiplies, it divides. So after 90 days, you have two, and then another 90 days, you have four, and that continues. So after the first year, you know, you'd wind up with about 16, you know, of these cells there. After the second year, maybe you got 250 some odd. And after about 4 years, maybe about 65,000, all right? And then in the fifth year, it's going to jump, and you're gonna wind up with over 1 million. And then it'll take about until about the seventh year before you'll have about 1 billion cells. And at that point, that's when the mammogram can find it, because at that point, it'll be about the size of a small pea. It'll be physically there, and the mammogram will be able to find it.
Wow.
So you say there's a way to have earlier detection. Is that what you're saying?
Well, that's the idea of the tomography. So the tomography isn't designed to replace it. It doesn't want to work that way. It doesn't want to find something after you already have the problem.
Right.
What you want to do is you want to be able to find something before the problem occurs. So the mammogram is very sensitive, all right? I mean, it can tell you that you have cancer or you don't have cancer. I mean, a mammogram doesn't tell you that either.
Right, right.
You still would have to do a biopsy. You'd still have to, in order to determine if it was, the cells were cancerous. But what the tomography can do is the tomography will be able to show you if there's any perfusion, any bleeding, if there's inflammation, and if there's something even more important called angiogenesis. Mm-hmm. And this is these micro little vessels that actually become capillaries in an area where
blood supply, right?
Right, where there's a problem. Where there's a problem developing, that'll happen in the body. The body will try to do that to try to send help there. But what happens is the cancer cells will actually start to use those little capillaries now to feed themselves and to start to grow.
Right.
So they kind of work hand in hand. One is developing, and the cancer cells are using what they're using to develop, and that helps the cancer cells to grow.
JP, how effective is this mechanism?
Well, like I said, it's what you're going to do. It's going to tell you exactly what is going on below, inside the body, and it's that infrared that's generating coming up to the surface of the skin, and that's what we're going to see.
Okay.
So what we're going to see is colors. It'll be like an image of the body, but you're going to see different colors. So the hotter and the more congestion, the colors will be like a red or even maybe white. Mm-hmm. And if the body is cool and you don't have inflammation, and you don't have that congestion, right, then you're going to have colors that'll be like green, maybe even blue, all right? So what we were going to do today was actually to show you how simple it is to do a tomography.
Okay.
So we're going to actually do a little a breast tomography. Mm-hmm. And we have a client on the other side of the screen here. Yeah?
Okay.
And we're going to actually do it live.
Awesome.
All right. So what's happening, I mean, I'm we're looking at the screen here at the same time we're talking.
Yes.
Right? All right. So we have actually, our patient is actually behind the screen there. And what we would do is we would take the shot. So this first shot, right, is just a straight on shot. All right, and we just capture that image. And you can see the image is down in the left-hand corner.
Okay.
All right, now the patient is turned to turn a little bit further to your left, a little more to the left. All right.
That is freaking awesome.
All right, and let's just take the overlays out. All right. Well, what you're seeing, just turn a little more to the left, please. All right, just about right there. Okay. And now we're going to just capture that shot. Okay. What you're seeing here is, if you look at, well, the breast right now here is blue. It's very cool. So that means that there is no congestion in that area. But these areas where you're looking, that you're seeing different, like white, or the right under the arms now, you will see this area here. This is like an inflammation. This is actually right under the arms. There's a lot of lymph glands right there.
Is that what we're looking at right there? Is that the red?
Yeah, all that red that you're looking at right there.
That's the lymph system?
Right. And well, that is basically your lymph system and it's showing. Now you see I can move the photo, the camera over. I don't have to be with the client. Mm-hmm. The client's on the other side there. But the camera is actually fully automatic. This happens to be a flare camera. This is the top of the line thermographic camera that's on the market today. All right, so everything is fully automatic. So now we would just take the next shot. We just capture that shot on the left. All right. Now we're going to have the client just turn slightly so we get a 45 degree picture, about like that. All right.
And what is that white under her breast?
Yeah.
Well, what happens is the breast, because it's laying on the body, so is creating a lot of heat. So you have just the heat. Okay. You got the heat from her body, the heat from the breast. All right.
Man.
So now you might just turn straight again at the camera, looking right at the camera. All right. All right. Now this isn't just another shot here that we take. So these shots are taken at different angles, you know, for the doctors, actually medical doctors that are trained to interpret the thermography. They'll be the reading. Give me a straight on a second, just Jamie, just a straight. Thank you. All right. The medical doctors are actually trained to interpret what these congestions and these patterns mean. So those different modeled patterns that are, she just wiped across the chest there, the doctors will be able to actually to tell you if that's something normal or if that's something
that,
in other words, if there's something going on there. I mean, this is all, there's a large number of lymph nodes in the breast,
right?
But depending on those patterns, you know, you'll see different, all right? So we would take that shot there. All right, you can put your arms down a second.
So the results would have to be read by a physician?
Yes, actually, this is a file that will get sent, right? The whole file gets sent to the physicians, right? They're actually MDs, right? And they'll give us a report back in a number of days. It usually takes about 3 to 4 days, something like that, to get the report back. So the client will get a set of these pictures along with the report from this physician as to what their findings are. So the doctor may recommend that they do certain things to help to remove that lymph. Like, I mean, as a technician, I can look at that and I could tell you that she definitely could use a lymphatic drainage right now.
Really?
Right? Something to get all of that lymph moving, right? Yeah, see, I mean, so like there's just a lot of congestion there.
Where?
I mean, all under the arms, up over the breast, right? And then on the right side here, actually, Jamie, you know, just turn, just give us a shot straight on a second. I just want to show you the right side, the left side. Now, as you're looking at it, right, what looks on the screen to be the left is her right side. But now, that's her right, and that's the left.
What side is your right?
The left. You're looking at the left side is her right. It's a mirror image. It's backwards. All right. Now, on the right side here, right? Well, on her right side, on the left side on the screen, you'll see that kind of inflamed reddish area there.
Right, under the breast.
That's an area about where your liver is. All right. So there may be some inflammation there with the liver. Again, we're not medical doctors. We're not going to diagnose and tell you that you have a problem there.
But that could be
what's something going on.
Could she also have inflammation in her fat storage?
Well, it'd be possible, but not too likely. I mean, see now below that, you see a little bit of inflammation, also another inflamed area there. That's about right where the colon is making the turn under the liver. So that's
on the right side.
On the right side.
What if she took her hand and rubbed on that area?
Yeah, just touch that area there.
Just rub
right there.
Up higher.
Up higher. He wants to go higher. Yeah.
So my hands are colder than my body.
Yeah, well, she's going to cool the area slightly. Now, you're going to have to wait. Now, see, once you've done something like that, you have to wait now for the body's heat and everything will all come to the surface again. So it'll take, see, it's starting to come back already, see? It'll come back, but it takes a little bit of time to come back once you've done that. That's why when you do a thermography, before you go, you know, you want to get out of the shower, you want to come there, you don't want to wear a bra, you don't want to do any exercise, you don't want to drink anything hot, because all these things can change that temperature.
Right.
All right?
Wow.
Why is like one side bluer than the other? Like the left breast...
Well, this is the area that because, whatever is going on in that area, that's what's happening, that's what's going on in that part of the body. Now, if you see up on the right side of the screen, up by her neck, you see that little white spot right there?
Right.
You see that? All right. So this is the carotid artery is right there.
Right here.
Yeah. So she's generating a lot of heat there. So again, there that may be some there's some sort of inflammation maybe in the in that area there. But once again, we need to wait for the doctor to tell you. I mean, I can kind of give you an idea what you're looking at, but we're not going to diagnose. I mean, that's not what we do. But they you will get a report back from the doctors, and they'll let you know what you're looking at.
Awesome.
There. Yeah.
So what is the cost for this type of procedure? Is it very expensive?
Well, to
JP?
to do a breast tomography, the breast tomography is $300, right? And that is it gives you, you know, you get the pictures and this whole file gets sent to the doctors. It comes back with a report. You get the report back. You know, we'll again sit with you again, explain to you what they're telling you mm-hmm. in that report. And, you know, you may want to take that report with you to your doctor, right? So you'll get a copy of the report. So,
wow, that's incredible.
I mean, now you can do a what we call a health screening, which is about half of the body, right? Which, you know, you'll get the chest, you'll get the back, you'll get the head, you'll get the thyroid area, you know. So that's a little bit more money. That's like $475, and then you can do a full body, which is $675, mm-hmm. and the full body is everything: hands, feet, the legs, everything. Now, sometimes you'll see, like in a tomography, just to give you an example here, like somebody's hands, they may have be like appear red, all right? And this is like we call a red glove. Mm-hmm. Look just like you have a red glove on. Jamie, just put your hand on the screen there, all right? See her hands are like, see the green, that's a normal color, all right? Even the blue, right? But if a hand was all red, that can be an indication that you may have some sort of a diabetic problem. All right.
Circulation.
Yeah, or if we were doing a tomography and you're in the chest area, and at the time you do it, you get a big blue area on the right over the heart. What's happening there? The heart is in some sort of a trauma, and is drawing all of the blood back into the heart to try to help itself. Mm. That's a person you might want to call 911 and get them right to the hospital.
Wow.
So the difference between blue and red is red means
is temperature, is cooling. The blue is cool. The blue is your coolest. Black is the see the black in the background. There's no
right.
heat back there. The black. The blue is cooler. Then the green, and then as you start to go into the other colors, like the orange and the yellow, the reds, you know, like that, and up to the white.
And white is white.
White is really a pretty extreme amount of heat is being generated.
That's what I had when I did it at that fair.
Yeah, right.
This was
well. You'll always get in the opening. Now, if you would do you know, like the, you know, the face here. We'll just I'm going to look at your face here a little bit, Jamie. All right.
Well, that's kind of freaky.
All
right.
Ooh.
Sexy. All right. Oh, girl. Oh, I see some teeth.
Yeah, well, you see now, you see what happened when she opened up her mouth. Now you see that white coming through.
That
you also
scary.
See that in right where the eyes are, there's some heat coming through there. All right. She has a nice cold nose, just like a good puppy. But you see the again, you can see in the area by the neck, the white spots that are to the left and a little bit even to the right there. All right. Now, if she turns to the side. Now, you'll notice the hair. See, the hair, the infrared won't go through the hair.
Right.
So if you're doing any kind of headshots, you need to, you know, lift the hair off the neck in order to see it better.
It'd be interesting to see my bald head on there.
Yeah, well, it would be probably like just some glowing white.
Really?
Yeah. Because you're such a hot guy. So, but this image here with the face, you know, the headshot, right? You'll also can look at the teeth. You see the whole area of the mouth. I mean, there is like some inflammation, like a little more inflammation than should be normal around the area of the mouth. All right.
That's amazing.
That's really
but you see the camera. You see the jewelry on the hand. The camera is so sensitive. Mm-hmm. I mean, the camera pick up, you know, like you see it pick everything up. This, you know. I mean, it's a very sensitive camera. This camera actually, the last camera we had was about 1,500 pixels. This one is 305,000.
Wow.
So this is an extremely good camera.
Wow. I'm just lost for words.
Well, now, just here's something else. We just a little bit of information here. This is something that's a report from the New England Journal of Medicine about tomography,
mm-hmm.
and it's a report. It's kind of pretty disturbing because they've they're estimating that in the last 30 years that there was somewhere around 1.3 million women that were actually kind of diagnosed a little bit wrong.
Right, I heard about that too.
They were kind of overdid this mammography, you know, and they've everybody seemed to have a lot of cancer that maybe that they didn't really have cancer.
So, misdiagnosed, wow. So many people.
So this is something right in the New England Journal of Medicine that, they were trying to just let the doctors know that, look, you know, maybe you need to slow down a little bit. And that's probably one of the reasons why now they're saying, you know, older women to start with the mammograms and not the younger ones. Mm. But again, this is something that you're looking to find, you know, the problem when it's only in the infancy stage, when it's just beginning, all right? So that change when you only have, you know, 100 or 200 cells in that first year or 2 years, and it hasn't become a problem where you would be able to do things like change your diet, right? Do your coffee enemas, do all kinds of things that could help you to, you know, eliminate the cancer before it starts to become a tumor and you have a problem.
So JP, we're gonna take a break right now, and during the break, I'd like either myself or the body mechanic to go back behind the screen. Is that possible?
Oh, that's very possible.
I'd love to take a picture of me, see what I look like.
All right, we'll be
right
back.
That's very possible.
Yes.
For professional motorcycle transport and towing, think Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing. Proudly serving all of Long Island, we feature expert handling and 24/7 service. So send a limo for your toy with Kickstart Fabrications Motorcycle Towing.
Spice body spray will make you feel so powerful to blow your mind right in front of your face.
Goodbye.
Oh no!
Automatic freshness, softness, and static control has never been easier with the Bounce Dryer Bar. I just stick it to the inside of my dryer and I never have to remember.
Oh! Spice body spray makes you smell like power! It's so powerful, it sells itself in other people's commercials. You smell like outdoor freshness.
You smell like power.
Yeah, I do. Power!
Try this routine to feel fresh and clean. Pair Charmin Freshmates with your Charmin.
Oh, Spice Body Spray is too powerful to stay in its own commercial! That's right. Power! Whoa! Old Spice Body Spray can change a regular smelling man into a man who smells like power!
Now, how is this? Wow, you know what? I actually do feel more power.
Potato chips! Power! It's me.
Eva, one of our 4 million owners, has her cat insured with Folksam. This one is for you.
I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. I think about it every night and day. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly.
Visit folksam.se and tell us what makes your heart beat faster.
Welcome back to Bishop TV. My name is Chella, and we have the body mechanic behind the magic screen.
Yes, I am behind the magic screen.
Before we go to you, body mechanic, we have a phone call. Hold on, dear. Welcome to Bishop TV. Welcome, welcome. All right, maybe they'll call back. All right, so JP, we have the mighty man behind the screen.
Yes. You know what? I just wanted to show you this little picture here.
Okay.
All right? This is kind of a like a before and after. So this is the original shot of one of our clients, right? And you can see the rest, the right side is green, all right, which is a nice, what it should be.
Uh-huh.
On the other side, the left breast, we have a little bit of inflammation going here, all right? Now, after what we did here, the doctor recommended a 3-month follow-up. Mm-hmm. He recommended that she do lymphatic drainage. And also there was some herbal treatments that were done that she was on, and we have these things, these breast creams and things that can also help. And then this was her again now, three months later, all right?
3 months.
This is 3 months later. Now, we still have a little inflammation going, but nothing like was what happened. But that's in three months.
Great improvement.
Yeah, well, that's the idea. So the idea is to catch it early and that you can make a change pretty rapidly.
Very nice. Right?
Now,
Body Mechanic, you are behind the magic screen.
Yes, I am.
And you look like a monster from Star Wars.
Okay, so we're looking right now at his head and his upper body, all right? And what we're noticing right here, all right, there is a little bit of inflammation right across the shoulder areas there.
You is see that the left shoulder?
The left in
yes,
particular.
Yes, big time.
The left
that's
is where, much
that's
more.
Where I have an issue.
Right.
Right here.
Yeah, that's
yes.
it, right? Yeah, right that. Here. Well, it's there. It's that whole area. That whole area is all inflamed, all leading right up, you know, going up the cervical, up the which is the lymphatic nodule.
Well, look down his.
Let's
his,
just turn. His, try turning to your right. And let's just see what we see on the side. All right. Now, on the side we're looking at, there's a little bit of inflammation on the jawline, right? Right there. You got it. Right there. So I mean, there's something probably happened
below
there.
Below that.
Yeah, a little bit lower now, going down into lymphatic. All right. So
that's where I had a tooth removed.
All right. So well, that's what it is. So you have some sort of problem in that area, and that's what it's picking that up. All right. Now, otherwise, he has, as you notice, his nose is, he has a blue nose, it's nice and it's cool.
His ear. Right?
The ear, well, that's what would happen, the outside of the ear, it's cartilage, it would be like that. Otherwise, the hair, going up on the right, on the side of the head, above the ear, right at the temple there, that's actually your triple warmer meridian actually starts right there. So that meridian, if you follow that, if that went up over the ear, it would come down the neck
right.
and just come down there and right across, around the back of the shoulder, it would go down around the back of the shoulder there, all right? So that probably what's happening there is the triple warmer, is that your fight or flight meridian?
Mm-hmm.
And that you don't only want that open during emergencies. You don't want that to be open all the time.
Right.
Is mine open?
Well, it seems to be. Showing that heat is right there. It looks like it may be open a little bit. But that we can close by just following it. I'll show you how
Does
to do that.
Does that mean he's in defense mode?
It's to some point. That's what it is. Yeah, to some point.
Uh-oh. We lost your Body Mechanic.
Really?
He went to outer space.
So much heat that it turned the camera on.
I just know. Have to dunk, too much fight or flight.
Yeah, maybe. Yep.
Too much energy, Body Mechanic.
No, try just the green button. Yeah, the green one that's on. Just hit it off.
How's
and then hit it on again.
Coachella.
Press it again.
Perfect.
Now. Press it again. And then step out of
Very
the camera.
Very round. I want to see the rest of your body, Body Mechanic.
Yeah, I bet you do, Chella.
And so You're does in, everyone else.
You better
Just try turn. Hit it again. All right, let's just give it a second. Okay, it should be coming on there.
This is so exciting.
We're trying
Very
to get the Body Mechanic back here. Is that green light on there? Yes.
You broke okay. the system, Body Mechanic.
No. Well, that can happen. I don't know.
Like the Matrix.
It's you're going to have to hit that button again then one more time. Just stay down, stay down.
When we go for a
Not
break.
Not many times, it's like.
And try to fix the problem.
Yeah.
Right, Jake?
YesWeCare.net is a 501c3 charity that provides help to veterans and their families. Please visit YesWeCare.net and donate in any way you can by purchasing our beautiful frame prints or relaxation CDs and DVDs, even smooth jazz CDs. YesWeCare.net. Remember, our troops are on their way home. They need all the support they can get. YesWeCare.net.
Welcome back to Body Shop TV. My name is Chella, and I'm here with JP from Optimal Wellness of Long Island, and we have the body mechanic behind the magic screen looking like Star Wars.
Yes, I am.
You have your microphone with you, body mechanic?
Of course I do, Chella.
OMG. Talk about vanity. So,
okay.
JP.
All right, so what we were talking about, if maybe if you turn to your left, and let's just see the right side. Okay, so now if you notice on this side here, on the side of the head, there's a little less inflammation. It seems to be nice. That's pretty much what you would see pretty normal.
What's that right? White spot on his jaw?
Right on the line there.
Yeah,
there's
yeah.
Something. Well, I don't know. I mean, there's a little bit of inflammation there. There's something going on there. But again,
is it right here?
No, down.
No, down under the jawline.
Down.
Under the jaw. Yeah, right there. Right in there. Yeah, see, that's down. Like an inflamed area. See, it's actually red there. It's not only that. It's not only the white spot, but there is a red area that's inflamed. All right, so there's a little bit of inflammation there. All right, and then down the back of the neck, right? Down the back of the neck, we got a carotid artery there. So there's a little bit, inflammation there.
Now, JP, when he was facing forward.
All right, you can turn forward again, please.
On his right side, you see that long red line?
Yeah.
What is that?
Well. It's showing that there's an inflammation there in that area.
Where, Chella?
On your right side.
Right here?
Down your throat.
It's here.
Right, from your throat coming down straight.
Aren't there lymph nodes in there also?
See how that lymph node in the neck is kind of connected to that?
Right. It's really lower.
Here?
Yeah, right there. Right there, yep. Up. So what is that, JP? And it's white in the center.
There's some sort of inflammation there that's going on there. I mean, it is that there is an area there that, you do have, lymphatic. There's, mm-hmm. it could be something in the lymphatic system. It could also be, something like arterial.
Are those your breasts below body mechanic?
You see them moving?
No, they're very big.
Well, we're going to move down to the chest area a little bit just to see how your chest looks.
Those are his All implants. Right? You can see the implants.
So the chest area actually, right? I mean, the coloring again.
So the light blue on the right side means what? Because it's not on the left.
Well, that area is just cooler for some reason. There's something, that I don't know exactly what's the,
Which
you know,
side
something.
Is cooler, the left or the right?
You're right.
Right, oh, over here.
Yeah, well, right on the breast there.
Right here.
Yeah. There's something just cooler there. Now, you notice when under the arms, there's a little, more heat is generated from under the arms, but
right.
also that he has. Now, actually, if you look on the right side, which is on the left side of the screen,
mm-hmm.
and you see that area that's yellow there, that's coming up.
And gold.
And it's kind of going up there, and it's kind of turning, like, right underneath what would be the bottom of his rib cage. It's a little bit of yellow there like
transverse.
That. Right? So, I mean, yeah, that's kind of like part of, that's probably the colon. That's, that's the ascending part. The colon there a little bit might be coming up. It could be a little bit of congestion and underneath there. On the other side, just turn to your right a little bit. I just want to just see in there. Yeah. So Okay, now on this side here, so we got, besides right under the arm, the little bit that's red there, there's some inflammation there. Again, we're looking at yellows. It's not like a lot of inflammation. What you're looking at right there, probably with a lymphatic, you know, drainage, you probably could do one treatment like that and change everything here for him. In 1 hour, he could probably look completely different.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, you would that would probably move right out of the area. All of that fluid, all of that lymph would get to just go, you know, get back into the blood so it can be cleaned out.
So his heart area looks good.
Yeah, the heart, this whole chest area looked all right. It's, you know, I mean, just again, you know,